Hello everyone, welcome to NetSet OS. So we were in the mid of the project where we were iterating through the items. This is containing in the cart and accessing the related product instances. So here we are using ITR method, which is in cart class. And here we have added product IDs, products to get to the product objects, and we'll add them to the cart. So here we'll be giving cart is equal to self.cart.copy. Let's put it in loop for product in products, cart str. We'll typecast it in product.id. For product, it will be product. Same we'll be iterating for item in card.values, for which item for price will be in decimal. Here we'll be keeping item for price. Let's import decimal first. So I'll be going above, and here we'll be writing from decimal import. So till here we got prices which are in decimal. Now we'll be calculating total price, where we'll be having price as we have calculated for apples, let's say 200, and its quantity. If it is 1 kg, 2 kg accordingly. So we need to multiply here. So here I'll be taking item price into item for quantity, which will be in item total underscore price, and then we'll be taking out item. So here finally we iterate over the cart items, converting each item price to the decimal. So basically this ITR method will allow us to easily iterate over the items. Now we need to return number of total items in the cart. So here for knowing the total items, we'll be using len method. So here we'll be making a separate method for len. Here we'll be counting all items in the cart. So it will be returning sum of item of quantity for item in self dot cart dot values. So by this we'll be getting sum of quantities whichever present in cart. Now we'll be adding a separate method for which it will calculate total cost of items in the cart. So here we'll be making different function get underscore total underscore price, and here we'll be getting sum of, which will be returning the sum of item price into quantity. So here it will be in decimal form into quantity for item in cart.values. Now we'll be adding a method to clear the cart session. So here we'll be making the function with the name clear. So here we'll be using DL self dot session, which are in settings dot cart underscore session underscore id, and after that it will be saving. So here we'll be calling save method. So here our cart class is now ready for managing shopping carts. So after this we need to create a view, shopping cart view, where this view will be removing items from the cart, will display cart items and its total price, and also it will be updating items in the cart. So basically we need to do three tasks: add, remove and display. So first of all, we'll be adding items to the cart. Now here in the cart application directory, we'll be making a new Python file forms. Here we'll be writing the code to allow the user to select the quantity. So let's start writing from Django import forms, then we'll be adding class cart add product form, where we'll be having forms dot form. Let's keep here quantity and override. In quantity we'll be keeping type choice field. So here forms dot, if I write T, there will be type choice field. So here choices will be for product, quantity, choices, and here course will be int. Let's define it first. Before class, for I and str of I, for I in range from 1 to 20. Then let's define for override, which will be keeping for boolean. So forms dot boolean field, and it's not compulsory required, so let's keep it false. Initial false, and widget forms dot hidden input. So basically we are using two fields, quantity and override. Quantity, which allows the user to select the quantity between 1 and 20. Here we'll be using type choice field, and the quotient will be to convert input to the integer. Then we have the second field, override, which allow user to indicate whether the quantity has to be added to any existing quantity. If existing quantity has to be overridden with the given quantity, we'll be using hidden input, as we don't want it to be displayed to the user. Now we'll be going to cart, and inside cart directory views.py, and here let's write the code. So we'll define the function cart underscore add, which will contain request and product ID. Here it will have cart is equal to cart request. Cart need to be imported, so from dot cart import cart, then product equal to get underscore object or 404 for product and ID, which will be containing product underscore ID. Let's import it first with render, and this also we need to import. So we'll be writing from online shop dot models import product, then form equal to cart add product form. Here it will be having request dot post. Let's import from dot forms import cart add product form. Now we'll be writing if form dot is valid, then cd is equal to form dot cleaned underscore data, and cart will add product quantity and override quantity, which will be equal to cd override, and at last it will be returning redirect. Let's import redirect cart underscore detail, and here we'll be using one more decorator from Django dot views dot decorators dot http import require underscore post. So here we'll be using with at the rate require underscore post. So basically we are using require underscore post decorator to allow only post request. Here, the view receives the product ID as a parameter, and we retrieve the product instance with the given ID. And then cart add product form will be validated. If the form is valid, then either we need to add or update the product in the cart. So the view redirects the cart detail URL, which will display the content of the cart. Now we are going to create cart underscore detail. So we need a view to remove items from the cart. So here itself we'll be making one more function, def cart underscore remove. Here we'll be having cart request and product. So I'll copy from here and we'll paste here, and with this we'll be adding cart dot remove of product so that we can remove the products from the cart. And at last it will redirect to cart underscore detail. Now finally we need a view to display the cart. So what I'll do, I'll make one more function with cart underscore detail. Here we'll be having just request in the parameter, and here it will return to request from cart. Under cart there will be detail.html, which we'll be making shortly. Let's give cart colon cart. Here we have cart underscore detail. This is the view to get current cart to display it. We have created views to add items in the cart, update quantities, remove items from the cart, as well as display the cart content. Now we'll be adding URL patterns for these views. So here inside cart, so here in the cart directory, we'll be making one more Python file with URLs, right? Now inside URLs, let's write few code from Django.urls import path. Then we'll be importing views from dot import views. And here we have application as cart, right? Now let's write URL patterns where we'll be defining various path. So first let us define for empty path, that is the home page when we don't give anything. So here if I write path views.cart underscore detail, then the name will be cart underscore detail. Then we have path for add in int product underscore id, which will be in views.cart underscore add, and the name will be cart underscore add. And then we'll be giving path for removing the items from the cart. So here let's put few spaces. We'll have remove instead of add, views.cart underscore remove, and here. Now with this we'll be editing main URL also. I'll be going to netset shop. Inside netset shop we'll be having the main URL. Let's add a path for cart also over here. So I'll write path for cart. Here it will include cart.urls, which will have namespace cart. Don't forget to put comma over here. And also make sure that you include the URL pattern before this online shop.urls. Now after this, we'll be going to cart.urls.py. Basically, we have made two things, cart underscore add and cart underscore remove. These are the views for which we have created views, but it don't render any templates. So we need to create a template for it. So in cart directory, I'll be making a new directory with the name templates. Then inside templates, a new directory, cart. And inside cart, we'll be making a HTML file, detail.html. So we'll be deleting everything and we'll be making a complete HTML file, for which I'll just copy the earlier detail.html, where it is extending base.html. Then it will be loading static files, and in title we'll be keeping the name as shopping cart. Now inside block content, let's end it here itself so that I won't be forgetting it. So firstly, I need to give the header. Let's keep it in h1 tag, and here we'll be giving the same name as shopping cart. Then table class, for which name will be cart, thead, for which we'll have tr, th. Inside th we'll keep the name as image, product, quantity. Then we'll be keeping a remove item and its prices and the total price. Now after this head, we'll be giving body. Here we'll be creating for item in cart with product equal to item dot product. Then tr, here we'll be have td for ahref, product dot get underscore absolute underscore url. Inside this we'll have image source link. If product dot image, then product dot image dot url. Then we'll close this, and in else static in image no underscore image, which is in png form. Then we'll close this, and if we are done with this, now we'll be creating td for product dot name, then quantity item dot quantity, and then we'll be having form action for url cart underscore remove. We'll be having product dot id, and method will be post. And after this, we'll be giving submit type. So input type equal to submit, for which value will be remove. Good to go. Then we'll be defining CSRF token. So here after form, we'll define one more TD, for which we'll have class num, and here we'll be having rupees for item dot price. Same we'll be defining for total price, so here we'll be having total underscore price. Now here we have open fit product, so let's and it. So here we'll be having and with and for. Then we'll be defining tr class for total. Here we'll be defining td, let's put it in angular brackets, and here we'll be having total, for which we'll define span period, call span, and then td class num for rupees, card dot get underscore total underscore price. So till table it is okay. Now we'll be defining paragraph class for keeping it in right side. So text right, we'll be giving ahref URL online shop product underscore list, and class will be button light, and here text will be continue shopping. Then after this href will be giving class equal to button for checkout. So this is the template which is used to display the cart content. Now we'll be adding products to this cart. So we'll be going to our main application, online shop. For online shop, views.py, and here we'll be adding add to cart button. So basically we'll be making use of card add product form. So I need to import card add product form, which will be taking from card.forms. Let's see, here in forms we have this cart add form. Now inside this product underscore detail, after product I'll be writing cart underscore product underscore form, where we'll be having cart add product form. After this product we'll be adding cart underscore product underscore form, and this will be inside here. Let's save it, and after that we'll be going to online shop. Inside templates, inside product we'll be going to detail.html. after this product.price we'll be adding a form action, where we'll be having URL for cart underscore add. Let's add product.id, for which method will be post, and here we'll be having cart underscore product underscore form, and for post we'll be taking CSRF underscore token, and then we'll be putting add to cart button. So here input type will be submit, for which value is add to cart. Now after this let's save here, and we'll be going to terminal. Let's run it again, and then we'll be going to refresh it once, and we'll be adding flaky, and here you can see we have add to cart button, but here photo is not visible. Let's have a look here why it is giving error. Basically this page was coming when I inspect here from product detail.html. So I'll be going to detail.html, and here if I see there is a closing quotes missing over here. Let's save this and we'll go here again, refresh our page, and when I go here we got image ₹40, quantity whatever you like here. Now when I add to cart, again it is giving error. Without an error, it doesn't mean that we haven't done anything. So let's try to solve it. In Django, it makes so easy to detect the error, as here it says the error is on line number 52 on cart.py. So let's quickly open cart folder here in cart folder cart.py, and on line 52 it's not able to detect this decimal because this bracket is not closed here. Let's try to solve by this. Let's close this and we'll save it, and let's put our finger crossed and let's refresh this page, and here we got image, product, quantity and remove, as well as unit price and price, as we did in cart detail.html. similarly, in search form, as we can see here, quantity 740, 7 4 280, 35, this is just 1. So here we got our shopping cart ready. So hopefully you enjoyed it. Let's do more of the activities in the next videos. So for that, let's meet in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you for watching it.